Good morning, dear students. Welcome to our online classes. At present, I am in 8th standard first language English class. In the previous class, we already completed the beautiful poem Imagination. So, dear students, today itself, I will send you the textual question answer of the Imagination poem, and you should write in a fair notes and take signature on Saturday. So, today we have to learn the new things with the new thoughts of the new poem, that is the bees, honey bees. So this wonderful poem composed by the soul of English literature, that is none other than William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare composed this one of the beautiful poem, that is the bees. So before we have to understand this poem, there is a warm-up activity. There is a warm-up activity or a pre-reading task is there. Everyone should open the textbook and observe the lines of the poem. Why? Because in that poem, some of the familiar words, some of the strange words you have to find out there. That's why you have to open your textbook and observe the lines with your running fingers. Okay. Shall I start the poem? Yes. The bees. Bees means what? Honey bees. Okay. Here the first question asked the poet to you. Have you tasted honey? How is the honey? Honey is bitter or sweet? Honey is always sweet. Just you have to understand. Have you tasted honey? Yes, I have tasted honey. How do bees collect honey? Do you know that? How these honeybees collect the honey? There is an answer. You must have seen the bees sitting on the flowers, going from flower to flower. They suck the nectar and store it in the hive. The long strokes are there like this. Those long stroke nectar sucking, that sucking those flower fragrance in their collection of honey. This is the process. This process we have to understand to help how the honeybees collect the honey. The next one is that, now read this poem and make a list of the unique qualities of the busy bee which the poet describes. Here, just you have to understand, in this poem, William Shakespeare mainly expression about the unique quality of the honeybees. Before I am going to start, I have to tell you two interesting points belongs to grammar, that is apiary. Have you listened this word apiary? Apiary means what? Here, the meaning of apiary means a place where bees are kept. A collection of bee hives. Here apiary means what? A place where bees are kept, a collection of bee hives. That means it is in your mother tongue, Jenu Sagarike Kendra or Jenu Sekarishuva Kendra. Is it clear? The next point we have to understand, that is apiarist. Who is considered as apiarist? Or else one more point is there, that is apiculturist. Apiculturist. both here apiculturist or apiarist. Here both meaning a person who keeps honey bees. Honeybees in bee hives. Yes, just you have to understand these two important point we should understand before we have to start this poem. What is the meaning of apiary? Apiary means it is a center. It is a place. A place where bees are kept or a collection of bee hives. The next one is apiarist. Apiarist or apiculturist. Both words, the same statement here. That is a person who keeps honeybees in bee hives. Bee hives. So this is the two. This is the farmer. The farmer or a person who keeps honeybees in a bee hives, he is considered as apiarist, or apiculturist. So now it is the time to understand the poem. Here everyone should open your textbook and observe. Here it is a very short poem. So today itself we have to wind up this poem here. So what the honeybees, creatures that by a rule in nature teach the art of order to peopled kingdom. In this three lines, William Shakespeare mainly expressed about that. What he expressed, honeybees, the people kingdom, the kingdom of the people should learn, must learn with the unique quality of the honeybees. Just you have to understand, here they have a king and officers are sorts. Sorts means different. Sort means different. Here in that Hermes group, they also have a king and officers, where some like magistrates correct at home, others like merchants venture trade abroad, others like soldiers armed in their stings make boot upon the summer's velvet buds. In this six line, William Shakespeare mainly exposed different kinds of honeybees are there. He divided into five kinds. Here the first one is queen honeybee, drone, the second next one soldier bee and worker bee. So these are the different honeybees we have to find out there. Who are the different? The one is queen bee. It's the first one. The second one is there, that is drone. The second one is drone. The third one is soldier bee. The third one is soldier bee. The next one is worker bee. Here, these are the important honeybees we have to find out there. So, what is the main duty of bee? What is the main duty of drone? What is the main duty of soldier? What is the main duty of worker? And some of the honeybees, here the honeybee kingdom. In that honeybee kingdom, there are so many. There is a king is there, officer is there, magistrate are there, and merchants are there. Venture means achievers. Achiever honeybees are there. And some of the queen honeybees are there, drone are there, soldier are there, worker are there. These are the different kinds of honeybees we have to find out in this story. But they are not forget their work. They are given first priority to their work. What is the work of honeybees? Those are collecting the fragrance of the flower. They are going to flower and collect fragrance of the flower. That is the duty of the honeybees. But the different character, the different departments of the honeybees created by the William Shakespeare. The same manner here, in the people kingdom, people are also different in the department, but they never given important, they never give priority to their work, their duty. They forgotten their duty, but they are going the other way. That is the comparison between the unique things of, the unique quality of honeybees, the unique quality of the peopled kingdom. So this is the difference shown by William Shakespeare in the poem of the honeybees. Okay, the next, finally, what he told here, which place the with merry myth bring home to the tent royal of their emperor. In their emperor, that means in the honeybees emperor, they are given priority, collect the fragrance of the flower, but in the people kingdom, the people never, ready to handle their work. That is the two difference between. So next we need there, who busied in his majesty surveys the sings masoons building roofs of gold. Honeybees, we have to find out there in a different manner, in a different ways. That is, the first one is singing masoons, building roofs, that is the gold. The honeybees, these honeybees sitting in one side, they are collecting the fragrance of the flower. That is the main thing in this story. The civil citizens kneading up the honey, the poor mechanic potters crowding in their heavy burdens at his narrow gate, the sad-eyed justice with his surly hum delivering over to executors pale the lazy yawning drone. So here the duty in the last stanza of the poem, William Shakespeare mainly expressed that the queen, the drone, soldier, worker, honeybees are there doing their duties at the time when they are collected their honey or fragrance of the flower. At the time, human beings needed that desire, that honeybees, they only stolen by the thieves. In that we use, so at the time these honeybees are very nervous. Why? Because they try to work hard to collect the fragrance, going to flower. That is the major theme of this poem. That means in this story we have to understand there is a difference between people kingdom and honeybees kingdom. Honeybees are sure that they are a unique quality, but man kingdom or people kingdom never shown like that unique quality. This is the story of the honeybees poem. So today this poem is completed. Today itself I will send you two poems, a textual question answer. You should write in the fair notes and take signature on Saturday. Thank you.